an elimination of the Illinois State Fair Colt Stake for two-year-old trotting fillies. Number one, Lone Hill St. Teresa, owned by Richard and Ann McKibben of Annawan, Dick McKibben, the trainer driver. Number two, Emily Ann, owned by Jerry and Helen Logan of Coffeyville, Kansas, trained by Jerry Logan, Brent Holland in the bike. Number three, Fox Valley Patrice, owned by Fox Valley Standardbreds by Jack and Peggy Hood, trained by Tony Alanya, Dave McGee will drive. Number four, Wetland, owned by H. Phil Pierce of Carmi, trained by Buddy Simpson, Clay Simpson driving. Number five, Classic Velvet, owned by Julius Mooney of Pocahontas, trained by Morris Rockers, Andy Miller will drive. Number six is Swiss Jade, owned by Mary Lee Jeffers of Flat Rock, John David Finn, the trainer driver. Number seven, Forever Roses, owned by Bambi and Jim Fox of Paducah, Kentucky, trained by Jim Fox with Connell Willis in the bike. And number eight, Princess April, owned by Richard Warlow Jr. of Kewaunee, trained by Bobby Weber. It is Rod Freeze who will drive. Post time for the third race in just 3 minutes, only 3 minutes. Right now, here they come for today's third race. They're off and trotting. Classic Velvet goes out for the lead. Princess April is right there on the outside. Lone Hill St. Teresa gets away third. Swiss Jade is away trotting in fourth. Then Emily Ann just inside of Forever Roses heading into the first turn. Up front, they're being led by Classic Velvet, who gets over next to the rail, leading Princess April by just a length. Lone Hill St. Teresa made a break going toward the quarter-mile mark, and she drops back on the inside. Swiss Jade moves up trotting in third, and then Forever Roses is fourth. The opening quarter went in 29-2. Emily Ann is fifth, some six lengths off the leader, a gap of nearly five more to Fox Valley Patrice, then Wetland, and Lone Hill St. Teresa still off stride and trailing the field. On the backstretch now, Classic Velvet leads at three parts of a length. Forever Roses trotting up quickly on the outside to get the lead before the half-mile mark. Princess April sitting third just in front of Swiss Jade. Forever Roses has now made the top and leads it by a length and a half, the half-mile mark, and 101. And four, it is Classic Velvet who races in second by a length. Swiss Jade third by a head, keeping Princess April pinned down fourth on the inside. Fox Valley Patrice is fifth and moving up in the outer flow, four lengths off the lead. Emily Ann is shuffled on the inside, five lengths from the front. Wetland joins her, and Lone Hill St. Teresa is trailing the field at the three quarter. And they're all chasing Forever Roses, who leads it by one length now, trotting past the three quarter mile mark with Swiss Jade inching forward, three quarters and 1:35 and 4. Here is Swiss Jade up to challenge Forever Roses. They're matching strides, three lengths in front of Fox Valley Patrice. Classic Velvet drops back through the field. At the eighth pole, Swiss Jade takes over, leads it by three, but Fox Valley Patrice is coming on the outside. One length between them, a 16th to come. Fox Valley Patrice moves up to challenge Swiss Jade. It is Fox Valley Patrice cruising by to win it by a length. Swiss Jade was second. Princess April was up for third, the mile 2:05 and 3. Fox Valley Standardbreds by Jack and Peggy Hood, trained by Tony Alanya, driven by Dave McGee. Number three, Fox Valley Patrice. This filly today makes her first lifetime start in a purse race and comes home with the victory 2:05 and 3. She is by Master Willie from the Armbro Charger matron, Fox Valley Trish, bred by Fox Valley Standardbreds, the co-owner. The 3-6 Exacta pays $35.20, $35.20 on the Exacta. Right now, let's go down to the winner's circle, and let's go down to Ed Teefy, standing by with the winning connections.
Thank you, Kurt Becker. Dave McGee, how you doing, hey. Dave? Former National Driver Champion Dave McGee here. No stranger to the winner's circle at the Illinois State Fair, probably nobody. In the past decade, has won more races here at Springfield than Dave McGee. Nice job, Dave.
Thank you.
That filly was making her first lifetime start for the money today. They must have had pretty high hopes. to have her here in the eliminations of the big one. Looked like she trotted that mile pretty handily, finished good last quarter in 29-4. She'll be a player in the final, you think, Dave?
I think so. I think the filly needed this race. She trotted in 2.5 early at Springfield here and then went up to Chicago, and she